Hey band, it is Mr. Winter with our Friday night checklist, COVID-19 style, so let's go through it. First of all, hat box. You're not gonna need it this year, so you can take the hat out of the hat box and you're gonna place it into the green duffel bag. Now, key note, when you put it in the duffel bag, we want you to put it in sideways. Don't set it in with the brim down or the brim up, might get smashed. So take the front of the hat, the top of the hat rather, and you're gonna place it into the corner of the bag, just like that. The second thing you're going to look for is your plume. Sometimes we refer to these as chickens. I want you to leave it in the cardboard tube when it's in your bag. And an important note about plumes, when it gets to be time to perform and we have to put the plumes in our hat, you're going to want to grab your number three item here, which are your gloves. You have oils and dirt on your hands, things like that. It can transfer onto the plume, which is made out of real feathers. So you always want to have your gloves on. And then most importantly, you want to find the end of the plume that has the metal part. You'll see here, there's a piece of metal, and you don't want to pull that. The temptation is going to be to grab that piece of metal and pull it out of there. We always push the metal through the tube, and that way the feathers that are on the plume aren't going to get bent or damaged. So you're going to push the metal. Once you see it peeking out of the top there, you can gently grab it, pull it out. And as I said, when it comes time for game time, you're going to want to take your hat, take the plume about a third of the way up or so, and firmly place it into your hat. If it's on your head, it helps usually if you kind of grab the brim here and steady it, and then place it firmly down in. Try not to bend it as you do it. You want to double check too on the inside of the hat. You'll see some plastic tabs, and you want to make sure that the metal portion is securely in those plastic tabs. Now, when it's time to take the plume out, go ahead, grab it, get them near the base, pull up, and when it comes time to put it into the tube, you want to make sure, again, that you are pushing the metal part. So you're going to take the metal, hold the metal part here, and push into the tube. If you pull it through or you shove it through backwards, again, you know, the feather's going to get damaged, and it's not going to be a good situation. So anytime you find the metal tube or the metal part, you want to push the metal. And then when it's time to put it back in, again, push the metal into there. So we've got our hat. We've got our plume tube. We've got our gloves. And of course, this year, we want to make sure that everybody has their mask with them as well. If you haven't had a chance to put it on, you'll notice that it has a loop, a large loop here, with a little adjustable slider. All you have to do is take the slider, pull it towards the end here, and when it's time to put it on, you're going to take the large loop, making sure that these little tabs are at the bottom, and you're just going to place it right over your neck. Take the ear loops, you can run the ear loops around here. And for most people, you'll be good to go. You won't have to adjust it. Now, you need to make it a little bit smaller. All you have to do, take the slider here, and you can move the slider forward. Or if you need to go a little bit further back, obviously you could slide it all the way to the back. And once you get it on, you can kind of figure out the best spot for you. Mine's pretty good right there. Again, a little bit tighter. Just grab here, pull it and adjust. Now, when we're in the stands, it's going to be masks on when it's time to perform. Masks will come down after we're done performing. Masks come back up. And when we're stepping onto the field, as we talked about, what we're going to do on the field is take the ear loops off. And this portion right here, you can actually just stuff right into your uniform underneath of your jacket. So you'll have your mask with you. We can wear it during transition times to help keep us safe. So again, make sure you have your band mask. Now, if the weather calls for it, we're gonna get our raincoats. We lovingly refer to these as Gumbies. This year, obviously, because we already have this awesome duffel bag here, we're not gonna need the Gumby bag. So you can take the Gumby out. And it's essentially flat. You can kind of roll it up a little bit. And you can place that into your bag. It fits really, really well, along with the hat, the gloves, the plume, and the mask. Now, again, there's no concession stands this year, so you want to make sure, if you need to, you can get a little bit of water, bring some water out to the game. If you happen to have some snacks, you'll be in good shape as well. So I've got my water bottle here. We're going to bring some water to the game. Perfect. We're good to go. And if you happen to have some snacks, you can throw some snacks in there as well and enjoy the Friday night even without the concession stand.
Hello, my name is Joseph Jarek. I'm going to be showing you how to put your uniform on. Okay, so first you're going to want to make sure that you have the proper under uniform on. That's your Colts band shirt, your shorts, and Catholic socks. You're going to want to make sure you have this on first because you don't want to get it all on and realize, I don't have socks on, and you have to stumble to your room and try and put on socks. That's not fun. You also want to make sure you have the right shorts, because if you're wearing jeans, it will show. They are super lumpy, they show through, it makes the pants tight, and everyone's going to know. You're not going to fool anyone. So, first things first, you're going to want to get everything out of the bag. If you take your shoes out first. Next, get your uniform out. Once you're done with that, you can put your uniform bag somewhere. If you don't have a clean place to set down your uniform later, you're gonna want to set down your uniform and use it as if your uniform bag is clean. However, I have a clean spot, so we're not gonna use it for that. Okay, next. You're gonna wanna get your West Point off if we're not using West Point this day. First thing you're going to do is you're going to get the sides first. If you try to take off the top of your West Point first and then you get to the sides, once you get the last button off and unzip the West Point, your entire West Point is going to collapse onto the ground. That's no fun. It's going to get dirty if you have an unclean spot below you. And trying to catch it in midair is not a game you want to play. Then you unbutton the top. Notice how it's falling? That's what would have happened while you're trying to unbutton the sides, and it would have fallen. Now that your West Point's off, you're going to want to fold it up. And the way you're going to do that is you're going to fold it so that the back side is on the outside. And then you're going to fold it like this, and then down. You want this because you don't want the outside of the West Point to get stained. And the easiest place to put it is where you put your shoes earlier. However, make sure that this spot is clean when you put it in. Make sure there's no mud, no grass. Just make sure it's clean before you put it in here, or else when you pull it out, you're gonna realize you made a big mistake. Next, make sure, now that you've taken off your West Point, the buttons on the side are closed. Now, you're going to take off your jacket so that we can get to the pants. You can try and get your pants off with the jacket still on, but that's a horrible idea because you could pull the pants, you can't see inside of them, it's just easier to take off the jacket. And what you're going to do now is you're going to take it and you're going to fold it just like the West Point was so that the outside is in so that nothing gets stained, and then you're going to take it and you're going to set it down somewhere clean, even though the outside's on the inside and nothing should be getting stained, it's still safe and better to make sure that you're not setting it into a mud puddle. Now, you can get to your pants. Make sure you haven't put on your drill masters in a second, because what you're going to be doing is putting your legs through the leg holes, and the bottoms of them are hemmed. And so if you try to shove your legs through and you do not do this gently, or you're wearing shoes, you're going to snag that hemming and you're going to break it. And the band moms are going to be very, very upset because they're going to be doing more work. So be good and make sure you're not wearing anything. Zip it up like so. Make sure everything feels good. Next, you're going to want to put on your shoes. You want to do this before you put on your jacket, because trying to bend down and put on shoes with your jacket on is not fun. You want a tight tie, or else your shoes could risk slipping off, and you don't want that, especially if you're marching while they slip off. Okay, next, you're gonna take your jacket, and you're just gonna slip it on. Now, Last step is zipping it up. What you're going to want to do is you can clip the back of it, but you're going to want someone else to zip this back up. You can try to do it yourself. That's not a good idea. You're going to have to be a real flexible person to do that. It's just easier to go get someone else to do it. I don't have anyone else here right now, so I can't do that. I'm going to have to go and get someone else from another room to do that. So, that's the last step. Your uniform's on. If you want to know, you can just slip on your pants clip, put it on here, put it into your uniform bag. Since we're covering putting on your uniform, in case you're going someplace and you don't need to have your jacket on, but you need to have your pants on, like say you're going on the bus to a long, faraway place, then what you're going to do is you're going to slip off your jacket and you're going to put this, just this, in the bag. If you're doing this and you're going someplace, and you're make sure that your West Point is how it should be. So if you're going someplace and you're doing West Point, make sure it's already on. You don't want to be trying to put your West Point on in a crowded bus. So then you can get there and just slip it on. That's it. That's how you get your uniform on. Hello, my name is Joseph Jarek. I'm going to be showing you how to take off your uniform. Okay, so first things you're going to want to do is you're going to make sure your jacket is unzipped. Now, mine's already unzipped, but if yours is not, which yours won't be, you're going to have someone else do it. Don't try to do it yourself. That's not fun. Mine is just unzipped already for the sake of ease of access, and so I don't have to have someone unzip it right now. So first thing you want to do is take off your jacket. You're going to want to take it, fold it to the outside. It's on the inside, like we did when we were putting on the jacket and we didn't need it. And slip down. Next, you're going to take off your shoes. You're going to take them off because in a second we're going to be taking off the pants. And you need your shoes off before you take off your pants, or you can mess up the hemming, and you don't want to do that. Next, take off your pants. Might be a good time to check to make sure there's nothing in the inside pocket. So, and here's the part that is most important, and I'm going to show you and probably overdo it just to make sure you get this through, because this is the most important part of the entire thing, is you're going to want to make sure that you fold these correctly. Okay, so the main thing about folding is you're going to want to make sure that you're folding along the seams that have been almost ironed on from whenever they've been cleaned. You see, it wants to fold along this seam. And you're also going to want to make sure that the seams, that the sewing seams are lining up too. And so what it will do, it will give you this flat appearance. And you're going to do that for both pant legs. Make sure they're flat and in seam. And you're going to take them and you're just going to do a little sandwich. And fold them up like this. And what it does is it causes this to be flat. Now if it's not super flat, sometimes you can give it a little shake and it'll sort of flatten out because there'll be a little wrinkle. And then we'll shake, we'll just get rid of that. So what you're going to do next is you're going to be putting on the hanger. The easiest way to get on the hanger is to take your nicely folded pants and you're going to slip it through the hanger and just pull it through. And so if you notice, while I did that, it sort of folded up. It's got a little bunch. If you look closely on this side, they're not even. And it's not even on the hanger. And so what you can do now is you can take it and you can grab the little sides, you can give it a little pull, you can adjust how it's sitting on the hanger, move it, make sure it's nice and flat, because you now clip it, and if it's not flat, it's going to be sitting like that for a long time. Also make sure, see if you notice, I should probably actually take the hem and pull it down a bit, so that's nice and it's about equal length on both sides. That is equal from the end of the pants and not from the straps. The straps are going to hang lower. So now you take your pants clip and you clip it on once you know that both sides are sitting nice and tight on this. Okay, so next you're going to get your jacket on. So this is a back. It simulates a back. And so the back of your hanger is where it zips up, because it's like how you wear it. So once it's on, you're gonna take this. You're gonna zip it before you do the neck. It's just easier that way from personal experience. Zip it down, get this back on, and if you see, I don't know, my waistcoat on, because in this theoretical situation, we performed in diamonds. And so last thing you're going to do is you're going to put your diamond, take your West Point, and you're going to put it on your uniform, starting with the top. Now that the top's on, you're going to button up the sides after you zip up. Okay. So, now the uniform is on, make one last check, make sure there's no stains, and now you're going to put it in the bag. First thing I like to do is make sure the hanger's getting through. Just slip it in, then take this side, slip it in, and you are good. Now, you can put your drill masters, make sure they're clean. If not, find out how to clean your drill masters. Pretty sure it's baby wipes, but don't take my word on that. Clean them off. Make sure they're clean. Don't want to get this muddy, because it's where you might put your West Point. So now that's that done, that's done. Zip it up. Uniform's all done. You're good.